Hi, I'm Dave Crane, and this is Turbocharge Your Brand TV. Just before the show starts, I want to share with you another Merlin moment. If, like me, you travel a lot, you're probably quite worried about what happens to your data. There's the stuff that's in the internet, there's the stuff that you keep in your hard drive. What if you leave it in somebody's office? What if you lose it? What if somebody steals it? Are they going to get all your stuff? Well, Merlin have the solution, the DataCrypt. In this, you have the same kind of keyboard that you get when you go to a hotel room and you go to the safe. And you put in your details, you put your passport in, your credit cards, your mobile phone, whatever it is, and nobody can get near it. The same with this. It's military spec, so nobody can chop it open, and even if they take out the hard drive, it's all encrypted, so nobody can get access for a PC to your information. Only you, because you've got the password. It's got super fast processing power, and so far, up to 2 terabytes worth of storage just for you. So the next time you're thinking about traveling, or the next time that you're worried about your information, get one of these, a DataCrypt. Very cool gadget. Just go online to merlindigital.com. That's it. Merlin, just for you. Meanwhile, here's the show. Enjoy it. Turbocharge Your Brand TV. Welcome to this week's episode of Turbocharge Your Brand TV. We're going to be looking at public speaking. What is it that makes it such a fear for everybody, and how can you overcome that phobia very, very quickly? We'll also be analysing how 95% of companies get their social media policy completely wrong. It's a small tip, but a little one turns into a huge impact for you online. And on top of this, we're going to be analysing one of the world's most bankable stars, Johnny Depp. What makes everybody love him? How does he get the work-life balance so right that he's one of the most bankable people on the planet, but you can't get access to him behind the closed doors because his life is so private, he keeps it to himself. We'll be finding out his secrets and more. Find out with the next episode of Turbocharge Your Brand TV. Is an essential part of getting you to where you need to be with your brand and with your future and with your success. This is it. Get a mentor. A mentor? What's that? Is that different from a coach? A life coach? A business coach? Yes, it is, because all those things you pay for, and they are very useful. Paying somebody to work with your business or yourself to develop you over a period of time with goals and so on is always good, but sometimes it's nice to get somebody who's at the top of their game. A mentor is somebody who's already been there, done it, got the t-shirt. That's a person who has been at a level of achievement, who was looking for somebody, or maybe they don't know they're looking for somebody, who can be their protege. And guess who that protege is? You. Think of the most successful person in the industry that you're in. Or the most successful person in the hobby that you want to achieve super high stardom in. And contact them. That contact should be, first of all, making friends with them. And social media makes it very easy. A great way of doing it is to find out, what is their charity? Who do they talk to? Find a way in so you start showing up on their radar, rather than just saying, please give me something, because everybody gets asked for something. But then again, most people have a fear to ask. If you ask, there's a better chance of you getting a result. So when you talk to your mentor or your potential mentor, approach a few and very simply ask them, do you mind if I contact you once a month? So now we've established the ways this communication can start. Why get a mentor in the first place? A mentor has achieved a level that you need. So all you need to do is ask them how you do it. Not everybody is interested. But if you approach them and say, look, once a month, all I'd like to do is meet with you for a coffee, or send you an email, or ask you a couple of questions, do you mind getting back to me? Now remember, a mentor is usually financially secure, so financially, they're not interested in your money. But also, when they take an interest in your success, that interest will go to their normal conversations with their friends. So they might start putting your name forward when something comes up that's relevant for you. If you're no threat to their own business, they may want to take you on and help you. And guess what? They're really connected to people who are very successful as well. And if they take you under their wing, they'll want to connect you with those people so you can find even more success. Remember to be completely gracious and very acceptable about everything that they offer you, because this is prime gold. So this week's cool tip, get yourself a mentor. Next up, we're going to be looking at your online game. How do you get online and make a huge impact for your brand, for your own personal success? This week, we're going to be looking at viral clips. What makes a clip so successful? What is it that makes people want to gravitate towards it? Addicted isn't easy to come by. For many organizations, they pay a fortune for marketing companies, video companies to create a really sexy video that nobody wants to watch. I'm not talking about TV, I'm not talking about cinema, because people have no choice. They're there to watch something else and the advert comes up. But let's look at YouTube. Let's look at all the many video hosting companies that are all talking about certain brands. How many of those brands understand how to reach people? I want to show you one clip in particular, and I don't normally show anything for this duration, but this is put together by a group called Lip Dub, and it's got almost 10 million views. All that's happened is a load of students have got together with a single video camera and primed up a load of things to happen in front of the camera for one take, and they've added some music. Possibly one of the most popular songs of all time, the Black Eyed Peas' I've Got a Feeling. Now, as you watch this video, I want you to think about two things. First of all, what makes it so viral? What makes it so cool that people who watch it tell their friends? And their friends tell their friends. And very simply, they go back and watch it again because they can't believe how cool it was the first time around. And also, how much money has been put into advertising to try and get that kind of reach and has fallen flat because it's been put together by committee, by so-called experts who don't understand what people really want to see. People power works every single time. Working on the emotions of exhilaration or sadness or joy or whatever you decide to engage people with, that is the magic of getting a community together and making something viral. So watch this, and you too will end up with a feeling. And turbocharge your brand TV.
Move it, move
just
it. do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, and do it, and do it, let's live it up and do it, and do it, and do it, and do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it.
And now it's time for this week's interview, and I get to talk to one of my very dear friends, Jeff Price. If you don't know Jeff Price, Google him. Jeff is a very successful presenter, he's run radio stations, he's written articles for various magazines, and of course he's been a TV presenter as well. He's also a lecturer teaching media students on how to create their own level and impact in the media world. I wanted to talk to Jeff specifically about public speaking. Public speaking is the biggest fear for anybody on the planet. The biggest fear, even more than dying. They say that if you're a good public speaker, you will make something in the region of 30% more money in your career, just purely because you can communicate better than everybody else. I would say that's a very conservative estimate. So how do you overcome your fear of public speaking?
Well, public speaking is one of the toughest challenges that any individual can face. The fear of public speaking is the biggest fear in the world. In terms of getting you out there to do public speaking, you've got to start somewhere. You've got to get yourself out there. If you get yourself just one engagement, you've got to have something to speak about as well. You've got to have an angle. You find that angle, find what you're going to be speaking to the public about, the after-dinner engagements, whatever it may be. If you've got a good story to tell, and you can deliver it well, then you're going to find that those bookings are going to come thick and fast.
Magic tips from Jeff Price. If somebody wants to become a public speaker and they're scared of an audience, how do you coach them through that initial step of grabbing a microphone and working?
We work through all kinds of exercises. Something as simple as tongue twisters, something that worked quite nicely with me. Red lorry, yellow lorry. We repeat that very fast. We repeat it a number of times, we get faster and faster, and we use hand movements, and we just get out of our comfort zone, because that essentially is what public speaking is. It's getting yourself out of the comfort zone. I've been speaking in public now for so long that actually a crowd of 50,000 people like yourself is my comfort zone. It's kind of weird saying that. You've got to get the individual out of their comfort zone. You've got to get the blood flowing. You've got to make them feel different. Just by moving your body, there's a physical change within you, there's a chemical change within you, and that's where the excitement begins.
And now it's time for Ask Dave, and I'm really excited about this because it gets to prove how 95% of companies are getting their social media policy completely wrong. Brian Lewis contacted me and said, Dave, my company's got about 5,000 likes on our fan page, but our business doesn't seem to be getting any better. What are we doing wrong? Well, very simply put, likes don't turn into cash. Engagement turns into cash. What's the difference? Well, in the world of the corporates, where they just suddenly got into doing social media, it's nice and easy to say, right, we've got 5,000 likes, we've paid for them, we've done advertising, driving people to our fan page, people have registered, and therefore we should be really popular. Well, no, for that moment that people click like, it showed that they noticed that you exist. But that doesn't mean that they're going to carry on noticing. It also doesn't mean that whatever you're talking about will show up in their news feed. What it does mean is that you've got to now start engaging those people, but you have got their contact details. If they said like, the odds are they've got an interest in whatever you have to say about your brand or any conversations that you're going to make. So go and talk about what they want. Post it as your brand, post it as you, but start the conversations coming. Make yourself relevant. Likes are great because what they do is they let you know who's had an interest in your brand. So you can contact them directly and you start finding ways of capturing their contact details so you can talk to them in email or any other system that you've got for engaging your audience. So likes aren't everything, but they are a good start. If you really want to make it work, connect with the people who've got clout online. Clout with a K. They're people like me who can get lots of comments and lots of conversations going every single day. They've got a community of people all around the world who actually like what we talk about, and that's why we show up more and more often. If you've got a strong brand, start making friends with people like me who are really having an impact amongst their friends online. Because ultimately, it's a very small world. The more small you make it, the more you better show that you're interesting. If you were to walk into a party and give somebody your business card without engaging them, they'd just go, right, insurance, thank you very much, not interested. But if you ask them about themselves and talk about stuff that they really like, they'd be into your brand because they want more from you. So Brian, that's a simple answer. Turn likes into engagement. Share people's stuff and start the conversations going. And I guarantee that will really boost return on investment for your brand. If you want to contact me, you can ask Dave at dave@thelifedesigners.com. If your question gets answered, then we'll give you an instant copy of a jump and grow wing system you can see behind me. Once you've got that, you can change your mindset, you can share it with your friends, and turbocharge your own personal success. We want to know more about you, and I want to make it more relevant to answer the questions that you really want to know about. Okay, it's time now for this week's case study, and I've chosen a guy who's a particular hero of mine, Johnny Depp. Now, I remember Johnny Depp years and years ago when he starred in 21 Jump Street, and he was just basically a teenage or 21-year-old cop fighting for his position in blah, 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 blah. It was a soap opera, good-looking bloke, but who would have thought he'd turn out to be one of the world's most bankable stars? Well, this is for a number of different reasons. It's also because Johnny has chosen his acts and chosen his roles very, very carefully. I only know of one time he's done an action show. He was starring in a film called Nick of Time. Google it, find out where it is. After that, he spent another 20 years doing lots of different films before he joined Pirates of the Caribbean. Intensely private, very, very successful by choosing the right roles, and aligning himself with the very best directors.
One of the greatest pieces of advice I've ever gotten in my life was from my mom. You know, when I was a little kid, there was a kid who was bugging me, you know, in school. And she said, okay, I'm going to tell you what to do. She said, the kid's bugging you. He puts his hands on you. You pick up the nearest rock or whatever you can get your hands on, and you lay him out.
Hey, Mom!
And I did. And I felt better. And it worked. And so, for me, you know, that was a great lesson, because someone had invaded my space, invaded my being, you know. And I was doing something against me that I didn't want to be done. So I took control of the situation and I ran with it. And many years later, after being, you know, turned into a product, you know, by a very huge corporation that had their hands all over me, and I couldn't escape it, you know, I promised myself that I would continue to move forward and do my best not to compromise in any way whatsoever, you know, not allow anyone to put their hands on me and affect me in that way. So that's the best advice I think I could give, is just to keep moving forward and don't give a shit what anybody thinks, you know. Just keep moving forward and do what you have to do for you, you know.
Thank you so much.
So that's it for this week's episode of Turbocharge Your Brand TV. I hope you really enjoyed it, and will spread the word and tell your friends all about it too. Next week's episode, we're going to be looking at passive income generation, how you can make money while you sleep, and how you can really boost with an excellent business tip everybody around you into joining your community. And on top of that, we're going to be analyzing the career of one of the most successful singers of all time, Madonna. How has she done it, and how can you learn to get all that energy, all that success, and all that experience, and put it into your brand? Find out with the next episode of Turbocharge Your Brand TV.